Wingfoot served up a recipe never before seen by the game's greatest players. Blessed with ideal weather conducive to championship conditions, the perfect storm ensued. It was as if the entire field of 149 players were dead men walking. An uncomfortable anxiety pervaded the grounds.
They talk about hard, fast greens. Well, we had them in 1974. Wingfoot was every bit of that.
I'd have to say it was probably the toughest test of golf that I'd ever seen.
The rough was too high, the greens were too hard.
You had to be lucky or a magician to get the ball close enough to par the hole.
Why? Happened to be Johnny Miller's 63 in the previous year in the final round of the U.S. Open. Said, we're not going to have that happen again.
63, the lowest round in Open history. 26-year-old Johnny Miller is the new national champion.
My name is Sandy Tatum. In 1974, I was a member of the executive committee that had the ultimate responsibility for the setup of the Open golf course. Johnny Miller's performance at Oakmont in 1973 was one of the premier performances of all time. In respect of the setup in 1974, there was a prevailing view that the severity of it was largely a consequence of our reaction to Johnny Miller shooting that 63 a year before. And I can attest without any ifs, ands, or buts that that was not a valid concern.
Regardless of why or how, the fuse had been lit. And the players were turning disastrous expectations into reality, including the event's so-called poster boy himself. By the end of round one, Tatum's setup had produced an average score of nearly 78, without a single player breaking par. And those were just the numbers. The anger and frustration seen on the course was largely taken out on the man deemed to have caused it all.
After the first round, the media approached me in a state of mind that indicated that we had done something that was out of bounds with regard to the setup of the golf course. The way in which the questions were put stimulated me to simply respond to them that we're not trying to humiliate the best players in the world. We're simply trying to identify who they are.
After three rounds, the few left clinging to that hard-line philosophy included then 44-year-old Arnold Palmer, 10 years removed from his last major victory. A 24-year-old Tom Watson, hungry to make his first win a major. And a 29-year-old with just two wins, who was ready to show the world his entire golfing soul.
I was addressing the monster, you know, Mr. Monster, you're a good guy, I like you, let's get along, and I'm not going to be able to tear you apart, so don't tear me apart, okay? You know, I just kind of made a pact with the course, if you wish. A little David and Goliath, but Goliath won this one.
With one round to go, Tom Watson leads. Irwin is just one shot behind, and Arnold Palmer trails by three.
Playing the last round of the U.S. Open with the lead, my heart was pounding.
Watson, three putts to fifth.
I didn't look at Tom's one-shot lead as insurmountable by any means. Whoever was in the lead, the one shot's virtually nothing.
While Palmer's hopes faded from a balky putter, the young Watson was getting caught up in the magnitude of the moment in the final group with Irwin, who was himself discovering the fledgling formula that would become the cornerstone of his entire career. Wait. Then pounce.
Irwin will be happy if it stops near the hole. A momentous birdie. Hale Irwin takes the lead for the first time.
It was now my event to win or my event to lose.
Hale simply played it as he needed to play it and didn't fight it, but simply analyzed it and performed in a way that made it such a very, very impressive performance on his part.
Back out on the fairway to the leader, who at this point is seven over. Hale Irwin right on the flag here at the home hole.
When you take a player's game to task, that's not embarrassing. That's testing the waters to see who can swim and who can't.
There it is, the United States Open champion. And there goes the ball.
That week, Hale Irwin was the best player on that golf course.
I never really did have any doubt about the fact that we had set up that golf course properly.
I don't think the players really have the right to say what a setup is. Our job's to play them.
What Sandy Tatum said there really applies to golf. It's the examination paper. That's what you got to accept.
If you don't set up a golf course like that, then a guy can hit it all over the place and still win the golf tournament. So you didn't identify the best player that week.
Today, more than three decades later, it's still legend. How a man, firm in his convictions, on hallowed golfing ground, took on the game's best and refused to blink.
I'm perfectly satisfied that we did what we set out to do, and we created what amounted to pretty close to being an ultimate test for the best players in the world.